About 8:30. That's just my internal clock, you know. So I don't stay up late, but we will be worshiping God into the new year, and it's just going to be a glorious time in the Lord. Amen. And also, next Sunday is our Mission Sunday, but until we get the weather a little bit warmer outside, we'll go ahead and just hold off on our outdoor services. Not something I really want to do, but wisdom says we need to keep our church and our children well. So we'll just wait off on that. But as soon as some good 60, 70 degree weather comes, and it'll come quicker than you realize, we'll be right back out there. Amen. Praise God. Okay, let's pray. Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord, for this time we can come to you in our giving. I ask you, Lord, that you would just bless this offering, Lord. I ask you, Lord, that you would multiply it. I thank you once again for your faithfulness, Lord. And God, it's just, you get all the credit, all the glory. It all goes to you, Lord. God, we just thank you. We love you. We praise you in Jesus' name. And everybody said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's sing that song again. Amen. Amen. Go tell it on the mountains. Sister Miranda's going to be taking the kids out. Amen. Amen. And they've got a nice craft in there. Now listen, hold up. Hold up. Listen up. Anyone that's bad, all right, is going to forfeit something at the end. All right? So you won't act right. All right? Go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead. All right. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. So blessed to be called his children. Amen. And I'll tell you, I'm so blessed to be able to be your pastor. Amen. I just love you guys to death. And you know that. And I appreciate y'all so much. Amen. And you guys really are, outside of the Lord and my wife and children, you guys really are some of the greatest things, greatest people that I've ever met. You've been the greatest things that have ever happened to me. Amen. I just love you guys and just appreciate every one of you. Amen. Isaiah, if you have your Bibles this morning, turn with me to the book of Isaiah, chapter number 9. And starting in verse number 6, I had another Christmas message that I had planned on preaching this morning, but last night at about 8:30, I was sitting there in bed, and the Lord started giving me another message for this morning. It is a Christmas message, but I'll tell you, we will just save that other Christmas message maybe for next week or next Christmas. Who knows? Amen. Amen. But I know God is wanting to talk to someone today. Amen. You believe that today? Amen. Amen. God is wanting to talk to someone. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. If you have your Bibles, Isaiah 9 and verse number 6, if you're there, shout, I still got my peace. Amen. I still got my peace. Amen. Isaiah 9 and verse number 6, and it says, for unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and and peace there shall be no end upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Amen. With the help of the Holy Ghost today, I'd like to preach for a moment or two just upon the thought of I've still got my peace. Amen. Say that. I've still got my peace. Amen. Help me pray. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, I ask you, Lord, for your Holy Ghost anointing to bring forth your word, God, unto these precious, wonderful people here today. I pray, Lord God, that this word would not return void, but God, it will have a permanent, lasting impact, Lord, upon the hearers today. I pray, Lord, for those that are here today. I pray for those that are listening through YouTube, Facebook, or social media. I pray that you would touch them and minister to them as well today. God, just have your way, God. And Lord, God, just move, I pray, by the power of the Holy Ghost today. And Lord, we just give you all the praise and all the glory in Jesus' name. And the church said, amen and amen. I've still got my peace. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, there is something that you and I as children of God have that all the money in this world cannot buy. And it's called the peace of God. Money may be able to get you a big house, a nice car, nice clothes, or fancy toys. But money cannot buy you peace. Can you say amen? Growing up, I knew of a man by the name of Buck Miller. And he was a man who had been gloriously saved and filled with the Holy Ghost whenever my dad was a young man. But somehow or another, he got hooked on gambling. And his gambling led him very far away from the Lord. Brother Buck began to play in pool tournaments in Las Vegas, and he would go into bars and he would hustle people and act like he didn't know how to play, and then he would bet all this money, and then he would go and take the money from the people. Brother Buck made a whole lot of money that way, but going to Vegas and doing all the tournaments, it just sucked him in even further into that life of darkness and sin. But it got so bad that Brother Buck even began to run an illegal gambling operation behind secret walls and secret doors in dark bars. Amen. And he made a fortune of money doing so. But one day, this man who had at one time been gloriously saved, gloriously filled with the Holy Ghost, ended up in a hospital. And my dad got the news that Buck was there, so my dad decided to go to that hospital and to see Brother Buck. Well, Buck said to my dad, "Jim, I've got a lot of money." He says, "These clothes that I have are so expensive." He said, "I never thought I'd be able to afford things like this." He said, "But I want you to tell your children, I'm the most miserable man on the face of this earth." Buck said, "Please, Jim, tell your teenage boys," that's what we were at the time, "tell your teenage boys to stay away from gambling." Amen. Well, Buck, as he was laying there in the hospital, he cried out to the Lord. And he said, "Jesus, if you will get me out of this hospital today, tonight I will be in your house." Well, it just so happened, we were having a watch night service on New Year's Eve, and at about 9 o'clock in the evening, those back doors of the church opened up, and here came Buck just staggering in because he was still very sick in his body. I remember he sat down towards the back of the church, and we all just kind of turned into an owl, you know what I mean? And we all just turned our head back and started looking at Buck. And, well, let me tell you what happened. Dad began to preach about the coming of the Lord. And right when that altar call was given, Buck arose from his seat in the back, and he went down to that altar with tears in his eye, and he gave his life back unto the Lord Jesus Christ. About 10 minutes later, God see, Buck knew, I may have money, I may have things I may have never been able to have before, but there's something that I'm missing, and it's called the peace of God. Amen. The prophet Isaiah said of Jesus that he shall be called the Prince of Peace. Amen. There is only one this morning who can turn your sorrow into joy. There is only one this morning who can turn your trial into testimony. There's only one that can give you beauty for ashes, and his name is the Lord Jesus Christ, our Prince of Peace. Can you say amen? Jesus left the splendors of glory to come down to be born in a manger. And when Christ came, he said, put me into a stable instead of a pallet. And when Christ came, he said, put me with a poor family instead of a royal family. He said, I want shepherds to be the first people that visit me, not the rich and the high class in society. That's why Hebrews 4:15 said, for we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmity, but was in all points tempted as we are, but yet without sin. Jesus knows what you're going through this morning. You believe that today, church? I said, Jesus knows what you're going through. He knows the pain. He knows the sorrow. He knows the hardship. He knows the heartache. But in the midst of what you are going through this morning, he stands in the door of your heart and he says, I still am the Prince of Peace. This world may be chaotic all around you. You may not know what the future holds, but it doesn't change who I am. I'm still the Alpha and the Omega. I'm still the beginning and the end. I'm still wonderful. I'm still a counselor. I'm still a mighty God. I'm still an everlasting Father. And I'm still a Prince of Peace. If you need peace this morning, just lift up your hands unto the Lord and say, Lord, I must have your peace once again. Oh, yes. I've still got my peace this morning. Yes, I do. Amen. You got your peace today. Amen. I still got my peace. Amen. Number one, I want to tell you that no matter what life throws your way, you can still have your peace. Amen. You believe that today, church? No matter what the devil throws your way, you can still have your peace. Amen. It was the Prince of Peace that said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. Of priests, he is that friend that is closer than a brother. Isaiah 26 and verse number 3, thou wilt keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee because he trusteth in thee. Amen. Let me tell you a little bit about peace. Amen. This last week in particular, I have had the devil trying everything possible to steal my peace. Amen. You ever had one of them weeks where Diane's already nodding her head? Oh yeah, Pastor Willie. Now, you ever had one of them weeks when the devil just stealing your peace, or he's trying to? Let me tell you about this week. Amen. Let me get on my soapbox, if you will. As you know, my children have been very sick. On top of that, we have had plumbing problems at our house. Under the house, anytime you turn the water on, it just pours out down the pipe. On Monday, we found out that our Expedition, our vehicle, had a major oil leak. I went to check the oil in it before we started heading to Madeira, and there was absolutely no oil in the Expedition whatsoever. And I thought, Lord, I don't have the time or the money right now to be making repairs. Amen. On Tuesday, we had to take Josiah to Madeira Children's Hospital. When we got home on Tuesday night, Miranda went to Walmart. Tried to start the car. It wasn't starting. Well, she called me. I couldn't get it started. The starter went out in the car. Oh, you see, we didn't have any money to repair it because a customer who had owed me $500 had not paid his bill on time. payments that I needed to pay. I had repairs that needed to be done, but because that person didn't pay their bill on time, it was throwing me into a lot of stress. Amen. I said, well, at least Wednesday is tomorrow. I'm going to go to the house of God, and I'm going to get refilled and get my peace. Amen. You know what happened Wednesday? I came over here. I started driving down the street, and I said, it sure is dark over here tonight. When I got over to the church, all the lights were out, and I thought to myself, here we go now. When it rains, it pours. You ever been there before, church? Every one of us, when it rains, it pours. Oh, but let me tell you what I begin to do, church. I begin to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Sometimes that's what you got to do, church. You got to push your way past your difficulty, push your way past your circumstances, push your way past the opposition, and say, hallelujah, anyhow. On Thursday morning, I woke up and I looked into my checking account, and sure enough, that $500 that I was waiting on had been deposited into my account. Give the Lord the praise today. Well, I had money now to repair the plumbing. I had money to do this and to do that, but there was a starter that had to be paid for. There were other things that had to be paid for. Let me tell you what happened. I never made any announcement on Facebook. I was in need. Never said anything to anyone. Didn't ask anyone for anything. But a couple of ravens gave me a call. Said, come on, I need to see you. Gave $500. Praise the Lord. Well, I'm telling you, church, God knows how to meet your need. Can you say amen? Am I preaching to anyone today? Has God ever come by and done the same thing for you? You didn't know how you were going to make it. You didn't know how you were going to make it through it. But suddenly the Prince of Peace, he shows up right in the midst of your trouble. And he said, peace be still. Storm go away. I am here. And I'm bringing my peace. Can you say amen? I believe that's what some of us need to do this morning. You felt the devil's threat. You felt him trying to destroy you. But in the midst of it all, begin to worship God. Begin to praise God. Begin to magnify his name. Peace will come. That's who he is. He said, I'm the Prince of Peace. Can you say amen? He is the Prince of Peace. Hallelujah. Oh yes, that Prince of Peace. Philippians 4, 6 through 7 said, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Amen. Sometimes when everything seems to be going wrong, we've just got to stay positive. Amen. Say that. Stay positive. Amen. I'm not preaching like Joel Osteen up here this morning, but I am telling you, staying positive is good for you. Amen. Sometimes we've just got to stay positive, knowing that Jesus Christ is our Prince of Peace, and he's got everything under control. Amen. Oh, yes, sure. No matter what comes your way, you don't have to lose your peace. Amen. Keep your mind stayed upon the Lord, and God has promised to keep you in perfect peace. Can you say amen? Number two, I want to tell you, regardless of your condition, you can still hold on to your peace. Amen. You believe that this morning? Amen. Regardless of your condition, you can still hold on to your peace. Amen. Philippians 4, verse number 8. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of a good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. Amen. Think on these things, God said. Oh, went to the doctor a few weeks ago, and they said, well, you got high cholesterol. I left there saying, praise the Lord, I don't have diabetes, I don't have cancer, I don't have this. I said, praise the Lord. Brenda said, you ain't gonna be praising the Lord when I'm done talking to you. And I said, all right. She said, I'm gonna kill you before your eating habits do. That's what she said. Amen. Well, you know what I told her? I said, I ain't receiving that doctor's report. Oh, I said, he told me, no, I can't eat any more fried chicken, no more pizza, no more donuts, no more meat, no more hamburger. Amen. Brother Wayne is shaking his finger. No, I told Miranda, that's a report that ain't from God, and I ain't receiving it. Well, I honestly did receive it, and I lost 6 pounds in 2 weeks now, I think. Amen. So thank the Lord for that. Amen. Our bodies are the temple of the Holy Ghost, and we ought to do everything we can to take care of them. Can you say amen? Oh, but Paul said, whatever things aren't true, whatever things are honest, if they're just, you need to be thinking about those kind of things. Amen. Whenever the Apostle Paul wrote this letter, he did so while sitting in prison, while Paul was under lock and key, while Paul was sitting in a cell, while Paul was around all these other criminals and inmates. Paul begins to write to the church of Philippi, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of a good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. What was the Apostle Paul trying to say? He was saying, regardless of where you may be now, you can still hold on to your peace. Can you say amen? I'm here to tell you this morning, you may have had to walk through the valley of the shadow of death, but you didn't lose your peace there. Why? Because he said, I am the Prince of Peace. Can you lift your hands and say, thank you, Jesus. You are my Prince of Peace. No matter what comes your way, the Prince of Peace just promised never to leave you and never to forsake you. You may be in a place that's uncomfortable. You may be in a place where your future looks bleak. But as long as you've got the Prince of Peace by your side, you are promised within the Word of God that He will see you through. Can you say amen this morning? Regardless of where you are, regardless of the way you feel, regardless of how you think, it does not change the fact that forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven. The Bible said that the just shall live by faith. Quit living by what you see. Quit living by the way you feel. You've got to base your life upon the Word of God, because the Bible said Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. If His Word was good back then, it's good right now. Can you say amen? Oh, yes. Hallelujah. When I look at the life of Sister Diane, I see a perfect example. I'm not saying she's perfect. Brother Wayne say, amen. Oh, but I see someone that regardless of their condition, never lost the peace. Amen. Didn't say never had some tears, never had hard times, but never lost your peace. Amen. Let's just lift up our hands up unto the Lord. Hallelujah, God. No matter where we are, God, we don't have to lose our peace, God. Hallelujah. Just knowing that you're right there by our side. Oh, God, that's enough to strengthen us. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. What's that old song? It says, hold to God's unchanging hand. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Things eternal. changing hand. Oh, that's exactly what Sister Diane has done. Oh, when blindness hit her as a young woman, she didn't start throwing a pity party for herself. She didn't start hating God and getting mad at God, but she kept worshiping Him. She kept praising Him. I'm telling you, that's what true faith is, church. It's when you can worship God in spite of what you're going through. These things have I spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. Amen. Be of good cheer, he said. I have overcome the world. Amen. Jesus gave us a warning. He said it's not always going to be easy. How many of you know life is not always going to roll you out a red carpet? Amen. Sometimes life will roll you up. What's the term? Chew you up, spit you out. Amen. Sometimes that's just the way life is. Somebody said, life isn't fair. Amen. Oh, I'm telling you. But I'll tell you what, you can hold on to your peace. Amen. Amen. Jesus said, because I've overcome, you can overcome. Amen. Brother Dave is here this morning. And over at his house years ago, I don't know if he still has it. It was a picture on his wall. And it had a picture. It was a cartoon of an airplane. And it said, God never promised smooth sailing, but he did promise a smooth landing. You still got that picture?
Yeah, it's in my bathroom.
Yeah. I knew I'd seen it somewhere. I just won't go say where I saw it. Oh, but thank God it may be a cartoon hanging in Dave's bathroom. Oh, but I'll tell you, there's a lot of truth to it. Amen. Oh, I said there's a lot of truth to it. God never said life is going to be a bed of roses. He never said you're never going to have any problem. He never said you're never going to get sick. He never said your family's going to be perfect. The Bible says that it rains upon the just and the unjust. Amen. That's something that everybody knows, that terminology. They know that section of the scripture, but they just don't believe it. Amen. I said amen. You ever wonder, as soon as hard times come, people start saying, God, I don't know why you're allowing me to go through it. There's been times before where I said, Lord, I'm faithful on my giving. Why am I struggling here? Lord, I honor you in this, but why am I going through that? Lord, I believe in divine healing. I've got faith. Why is my son sick? Oh, I'm telling you, sometimes we've just got to trust in the sovereignty of God. Come on now. God knows more than you do, and he knows a whole lot more than I do. Can you say amen? Amen. We're all going to have struggles. Amen. Oh, life can be hard sometimes. But the difference between us as Christians and the lost sinner out in the world is that we have someone that walks beside us and gives us strength. Amen. Y'all shaking your heads like, amen, I know that. Let's lift up our hands to the Lord. Amen. We've got someone named the Prince of Peace that walks by us. Amen. Oh, yes, church. God never promised smooth sailing, but He promised a smooth landing. Amen. As Brother Randy comes up to the piano today, I want to tell you that no matter what you're going through, you can hold on to your peace. Amen. Amen. I said, no matter what you're going through this morning, you can hold on to your peace. You know, the Christmas time of year, it can be extremely difficult. Amen. It really can. People stress about, man, now I'm going to be broke because all these things I bought, this and that. It's really the biggest thing, though, is our feelings. Amen. Those are the biggest hurts that people have around Christmas. Maybe a family that's in turmoil, family that's fighting, maybe relationships that seem to be going to nothing. Many times those things can bring the greatest hurts to this time of year. Maybe it's having Christmas when you've had the death of a loved one. It always makes this time very difficult, because you remember all the times that you had with them, and now they're up in glory. You're thankful that they are, but you're still here. You've got to survive this time of year. Let me encourage you. Somebody said one time, let me just give you some practical advice. Somebody said, well, my loved one's gone, I'll never be able to replace those memories. No, you won't. But just cherish them. Hold on to them. Rejoice over them. Think about them so you don't forget them. And go and make some new memories. Amen. Go and make some new memories. Make memories worshiping God. Make memories being a blessing to someone. Amen. Well, I'm telling you, church, despite where we are today, He is our Prince of Peace. Amen. You believe that this morning? Let's just lift our hands one more time. Unto the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, He is our Prince of Peace. Lord, we just love You today. We praise You today. We glorify Your name. Thank You, Lord, for Your peace. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Maybe you're here this morning and you say, Brother William, I need some peace in my life. I've been just really been under attack. Just lift your hand and say, Brother William, that's me. Amen. Oh, yeah. Maybe you say, Brother William, my family's been in a lot of turmoil. This time of year, it can be very stressful. Well, let me tell you, God is still God, and He's still your Prince of Peace. Amen. Praise God. The Lord's not in a manger any longer. Amen. That little baby grew up, went to the cross and died, ascended up unto the Father. Now He's sitting at the Father's right hand, ever making intercession for you and I. Well, I'm telling you, He is our peace today. Let's all find a place to pray today. Let's just say, oh God, may I feel that Prince of Peace today. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
He is my peace.
Oh, yes.
He has broken down every wall.
Oh, God.
He is my peace.
May Your peace, Lord God, just surround us. Oh God, you are our Prince of Peace. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, touch my sister today. Touch Sister Marlene, God. Lord, just may Your peace, God, just overcome her right now, God. Surround her, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
hallelujah, our peace comes.
Cast all your cares on
Him. Lord, we rely upon your word. Lord, we need your peace today. We need your comfort today. We need your strength today, Lord. God, give strength to your people. God, you are our Prince of Peace. Lord God, touch Brother Dane. Lord, I pray, God, that your peace, God, would just touch him. Your peace, God, that it would touch his grandma and grandpa. In the name of Jesus, bless them with good health. In the name of Jesus, God, just touch Charlie, touch Julie. In Jesus' name, touch his grandparents. Touch his mom, Lord. Touch Tanya. Touch Sean and Santos, Lord. In the name of Jesus, God, just touch Brother Dave's family. You are our peace, Lord. Oh, God, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, you are our peace.
My peace.
Oh, God, you are our peace.
Cast all He is my peace.